What is going on, Sith Nation? It's your favorite Sith Lord, Vader Dust TCG, coming at you with another YouTube video. Guys, today is a very exciting day. I just finished watching The Last Jedi trailer, and oh my goodness, it was amazing, guys. What a perfectly executed trailer. Rian Johnson, you are a genius. Your movie looks beautiful. And guys, today I'm gonna do a very special opening. I'm gonna be opening up one of the Pikachu boxes, three of the Mewtwo boxes, and an Elite Trainer box. But that's not all for this video. We will be actually watching the new Last Jedi trailer. I'm gonna play it here for you guys so you guys could enjoy all its glory. And after it, we will talk about that trailer because we have a lot to dive into. So yeah, guys, once the video comes back, this will be opened. So yeah, enjoy the trailer.
When I found you, I saw raw, untamed power. And beyond that, something truly special.
So what did you guys think of that amazing trailer? Isn't Star Wars just the best thing ever, guys? It really is. Look, guys, on this side are the boxes that I bought, and then this is the Elite Trainer box packs. I have them separated just so we can see, like, you know, the pull ratios on each one. But guys, there is so much to talk about in that trailer. What an amazing, amazing trailer, guys. And honestly, I just want to start off with that voiceover work by Andy Serkis being Supreme Leader Snoke.
When I found you, I saw raw, untamed power. And beyond that, something truly special.
And I'm pretty sure he was talking about Kylo in that situation, but there's also that slight possibility that he was actually talking about Rey in that situation, don't you think? Because what a coincidence that right after he says that phrase, they cut right into Rey in her, which is also such beautiful scenery, that Octu planet, very nice looking. There's where we're going to see the porgs and all those majestic creatures, because supposedly, yeah, there are going to be other, you know, inhabitants in Octu, which I can't wait to see those, because aliens and Star Wars have always been one of my most favorite things. So yeah, looking forward to that Jedi training that she's going to be doing in Octu with Luke. And that phrase that Snoke said, it could very well be talking to Rey. Also be talking about Kylo, but the thing I love about this trailer the most is that they're emphasizing a movie about four main protagonists, which is going to be Luke in his training with Rey, and Kaido in his training with... Ooh, full art Pokemon breeder. Let's go. The force is with us. Nice. Nice pool. So yeah, it's going to be emphasizing on that storyline between Rey's training to become a Jedi and then the training between Kaido and Supreme Leader Snoke. That's going to be my take on that whole trailer. Another very important thing in the trailer is actually the quote that Poe Dameron says. And in that quote, he goes,
"We are the spark that'll light the fire that'll burn the First Order down."
That's amazing writing, guys. And that's where Rian Johnson comes in. His writing is amazing writing. And we all know from the movie Looper. If you guys haven't seen Looper, please go do so. It's such an amazing movie. It's very character driven, very well written in general. Amazing, amazing movie to watch. That's so you could get familiarized with Rian Johnson's work. Very good movie to go see. So yeah, guys, please go do so. Support Rian Johnson, the director of Episode 8. Another thing that really had me going was when Kylo goes,
"Let the past die, kill it if you have to."
That is some hardcore. Ooh, shiny Mew, let's go, guys. That shiny Mew, nice. Look at that beautiful card, guys. Oh, yes. Yes. I can feel the force, guys. The presence is with us. But yeah, going back to the Kylo phrase that he goes, "Let the past die." That is some strong stuff. Like, really strong stuff. And honestly, I can't wait to see his character arc. Because when he was flying, that's another thing. We all know that his father is Han Solo, so we saw those piloting skills in that trailer. Ooh, Raikou Hollow. And honestly, when he was about to pull that trigger, I know they're trying to emphasize that he's going to blow up, you know, where Leia's at. But I don't think that's what's going to happen in that scene. But you never know. But he looked conflicted in that moment. And Adam Driver is such an amazing actor, guys. Like, that dude, every movie he's in, he stands out. And I can't wait to see his story arc. I want to see. Because to me, he can't be redeemed. He killed Han Solo. Han Solo died because of him. Which Han Solo is my second favorite character in the Star Wars universe. So honestly, to me, Kylo can't be redeemed. But you never know. He could very well be redeemed. If it serves a story properly and correctly, and they do it in a great way, I'm all for it. Redeem Kylo. It doesn't matter. It's all good with me. But Kylo for now has been one of my favorite characters from the new trilogy. And honestly, most characters are very well rounded, especially Rey being, like, you know, pretty much the first female lead. I know Carrie Fisher she wasn't the main lead. Like, the main lead of The Force Awakens was Rey. And I think, you know, J.J. Abrams for that as well. Because he did a very good job introducing us to this new world. Something else I would love to talk about would have to be, did you guys notice at the beginning of the trailer when Kylo's walking with all those stormtroopers behind him? Did you notice that planet looked like lava? I don't know about you guys, but that looked like Mustafar. And guys, if we go back to Mustafar in this movie, I am going to lose it. Because Mustafar has so much history, especially with Vader's lair pretty much being there. If you guys didn't know, a little fun fact, Vader's lair actually looms over the battle site where Obi-Wan beat Anakin in Revenge of the Sith. That's where we see in Rogue One, that lair. Yeah, that's Vader's lair. And guess what? Kylo's a big fanboy. So I'm pretty sure he would go there, you know, to train. Maybe there's where Supreme Leader Snoke is, you know. Oh, another shiny Mew. Let's go, guys. Let's go. This is why I do these Pokemon openings. Oh, yes. Another shiny Mew. That's my favorite shiny from this set, guys. Look at those two beautiful cards back there. We got two more packs, and that has all been from the boxes. The Pikachu and Mewtwo boxes. Look, we got, oh, Battle Royale. Only if they had lightsabers, right? Well, yeah, these are the last two from the boxes. Something else I want to talk about is Kylo's scar. Kylo's scar A lot of people were complaining about it, like saying, oh, it looked too small, it looked too this, it looked too that, in the first trailer that they released in Star Wars Celebration. But honestly, now we know why it looked that small. Because it's pretty much being healed with that magical bandage he has on, that badass bandage. So you could clearly tell that's gonna happen towards the beginning of the movie, because that bandage is pretty much covered. And then towards the end of the trailer, you could kind of see, you know, the scar is pretty much healed. Guys, I feel the force in this. I know you guys feel the force too in this last pack. Can we get some last pack magic? Can we get some last pack magic, guys? I know you feel it, because I feel it too. So say it with me. I am one with the force. The force is with me. All right, let's see what we get. Incineroar. So yeah, honestly, Kylo's scar looks really good towards the end. And I love how they're emphasizing. That's that Lucasfilm story group. Oh, Zorark GX. Let's go, guys. Bro, the force is with us for real, dog. That's it. That's it. I don't know what to say, guys. I am strong with the force. From those boxes, we got a Zorak and two shiny Mews, guys. This is going to be the Elite Trainer box. So let's see what we get here. And also, did you guys notice the forest tree that's on Ahch-To? There's where supposedly the Book of the Wills is held, which pretty much has the story of pretty much the origins of the Jedi, which if we do delve into that in this movie, I would love. I love history. And when they do story beats like that, and it pretty much serves the plot of the movie, and we learn new stuff about the Star Wars galaxy, I'm always for that. Oh, Raichu GX. Nice. Very nice looking card. I love that artwork. Very nice. Another thing. Did you see that battle between Phasma and Finn? Guys, for all you saying that, oh, Phasma didn't get enough action in The Force Awakens, well, clearly they heard you guys, because they're going to show us some action between Finn and Phasma. I can't wait to see that play out in the movie. Let's see what actually happens. And a Marshadow Holo. Another thing that really caught my eye were those AT-M6 Gorilla Walkers. Those things look insanely beautiful, guys. The M6 Gorilla Walkers really do look outstanding. I love, like, a lot of people are like, oh, they just look like, why is the First Order, you know, reusing like old concept from the Empire? Remember, they sprung from the Empire, guys. They sprung from that. So obviously they're gonna use a lot of, you know. Oh, another Zorark GX. Guys, I really want this card in hyper rare. So if we get a hyper rare Zorark GX, I am done, because that's all I need. But yeah, they sprung up from remnants of the Empire. They literally built the First Order from you know, generals and stuff that survived the fall of the Empire. So I really appreciate that. That's why the TIE Fighters and the Gorilla Walkers look kind of, but they've perfected their technology, which I like. It makes great balance in those movies, those new innovations. Also, did you guys notice those ice direwolves? Those ice direwolves really look outstanding. They look straight out of Star Wars Rebels, which I like. The connective tissue between the galaxy. It's very, very nice that we're seeing stuff like that. Because we know in the lore from the Clone Wars and Rebels, there's going to be wolves. And those wolves look majestic looking. Honestly, they look beautiful. Oh, Secret Rare Mewtwo, guys! Yo, the force is with us, guys. Look at this. Guys, we're getting amazing pulls here. Oh my goodness. Guys, look at this. Look at that background, guys. Oh my goodness. And we're talking about Star Wars and we're pulling amazing things, guys. This is an amazing opening. Amazing. And I know you guys noticed, going back to the trailer talk, Rey screaming and being, she was pretty much being force held. Like, you know how she was force held by Kylo at the beginning of, well, in The Force Awakens, not the beginning, but in The Force Awakens. We all know where Kylo learned that from, and it's clearly Supreme Leader Snoke, which Rey looked tortured in that situation, but absolutely tortured, which to me, he's trying to regain his true form somehow, and I think he's like a force vampire, just sucking up the life force of other force wielders, which that would be a very cool concept if they do manage to pull that off perfectly. So yeah, guys. Honestly, this has been an amazing opening so far. Let's see if it could even get even better. But yeah, and if you do notice in that scene that, Rey's being held by Snoke, because it's clearly Snoke. You could clearly see his gold robes sort of in the back, and you could also see the Praetorian guards in the background. So yeah, it's clearly Snoke, and I don't know where they are in that main capital ship, which is supposed to be one of the biggest ever, even bigger than the Super Star Destroyer. So that's also very cool. And one of the last things I wanted to talk about, guys, a lot of new storylines and story arcs that we will come out to play in this new one. And I think this will be the Empire of the new trilogy, which could probably even be better than the Empire, which the Empire to me is my favorite. And guys, do you feel the Force in this last pack? Because I do. Let's see what we get. Let's see what we get, guys. But yeah, guys, this has been an amazing opening, and I thank you guys for tuning in. And honestly, I would like to keep on doing, you know, Star Wars talk. So if you guys do enjoy this, please comment in the comment section down below, because I would like to do this more in the future. Talk about Star Wars, which is my favorite thing. And actually, I could probably show you guys my full collection of Star Wars one day. So if you guys would like that, just let me know. And a Palkia. What an amazing opening. I truly am happy that I was able to, you know, share this with you guys. Sith Nation, look at these amazing pulls, guys, and I hope you enjoyed this trailer breakdown. So yeah, my fellow Sith Lords, if you did enjoy this video, give it a like, a thumbs up, and please don't forget to subscribe. May the Force be with you always.